Good morning.
Good morning.
So let's take a moment greeting one another as brothers and sisters in Christ. Within our household groups, we can hug or whatever, and everybody else gets waves or bows or however you would choose to acknowledge one another. And then you all get to sit down. So, you know, we have the calendar year as far as seasons go. My weather friends tell me that officially September, October, November is considered fall. But the fall equinox is tomorrow, so fall, I guess, meteorologically speaking, would that be the correct term, officially starts tomorrow. And of course, that means, I think it's by Tuesday, we're supposed to be back in the 80s. Tomorrow, 21st. At least that's what's said in the paper. But you know, it's not like the paper's ever wrong. Early part of this coming week, fall begins. So we've just finished a book study, and several times during the course of the book study, we talked about within this thing we call grief, of just wondering how in the world people who don't have a church or a faith connection get through that and come out the other side of it healthy and whole. And so I just got to thinking about that. So you're in for, right now it's looking like about a four-part sermon series that I'm going to look at least four possibilities if somebody said, why church? So that starts today. And then music, it's just kind of a smorgasbord today, which you can see in your order of worship there. Still have upper room devotionals. Again, don't do us any good gathering dust here. So grab one for yourself. We got small versions for younger eyes. We have a large print for other than young eyes. For yourself, for friends, neighbors, anybody you think might benefit from a daily devotional reading, you know, take those, get them out of here. And then, as we concluded the book study, we talked about the possibility of starting another one at some point, maybe still this fall, maybe after first year, I haven't figured that part out. So one book I suggested is called Faith, Hope, and Hilarity, written by Dick Van Dyke, who gives credit to his years as a Presbyterian Sunday school teacher as to where he really started learning about what comedy is from kids. So I own a copy of that book, and it's up here. And if anybody wants to snag it after church, kind of look at it and give it a little bit of a read, I did find that we can find them used because it's out of print. It's a hardback, out of print. We can get it for like $6 or $7 on Amazon. So relatively inexpensive. So if you want to grab it, take a look, do a little reading, think, yeah, this is something, or yeah, not really. So we'll kind of send that around. There are Lord's Acre Days committee assignments up here on the front pew. If you haven't gotten yours, come up and grab it. My guess is whatever's left over from today gets a stamp on it and mailed. So we're trying to save some money here. So come and check these. And again, Operation Christmas Child. Did this box grow a little bit? Almost looks like there's an extra bag in it. Wishful thinking on my part? I'm not sure. So again, remember Operation Christmas Child, where we pack shoe boxes to go to kids who otherwise might not get anything for Christmas? And sometime mid-November, so about 2 months hence, that packing needs to happen so it can get where it needs to be by Christmas. So over these next 2 months, make sure as you're out and about picking up some little things that can go in those shoe boxes for the kids. And by all means, if you need some suggestions as to what specifically maybe that should or shouldn't be, talk to Carol, and she will be happy to give you some guidance on that. So, any other announcements need to be made by anybody for the good of the order today? Birthdays, anniversaries. I know of an anniversary, and I was hoping Larry and Nancy would be here, because this coming Saturday is a big 5-0 for them. So, maybe they just started partying early? I don't know.
Today marks 51 years since the big boy and I have been married.
Really? Wow. And today? Wow! So did you know you and the Shovers shared the same anniversary date? Just a year apart?
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, kind of, sort of.
Okay.
I knew ours was 1 year more.
Okay, yeah. So, and then for those of you who caught me before I threw my robe on, if you were wondering, why is he wearing a Jesus Christ Superstar shirt in the fall? Because that show is all about Easter. Ted Neely, who played Jesus in the film, is a friend of ours, and he turns 77 today. So I'm wearing that in honor of him. Nothing else? Anniversaries? Birthdays?
Is this the time where we tell you about putting people up for prayer?
Oh, well, when we get prayer time, we'll do that. I promise. And if I don't remember, you throw something at me. And I will not scold you at all.
Does it matter the weight?
Well, we'll get there. It's coming. It's coming. All right, so our opening song today, Linda is still not feeling comfortable in going places, even if she masks and distances. And a couple of you had said, you know, I kind of miss Linda, her smile, her laugh, her voice. And I said, well, none of us are singing. And then I realized the Clarion Choralaires that we sang in at some point during our years in Clarion, that there was a song they recorded, and she has one of the solos. So we're going to open with that, plus it's just a great opening song.
Thank you.
So as we come to our time of prayer, we have our ones that seem to linger. We still have this pandemic that is raging in some places, and in other places not as much, but still very much a concern. I know I've had, it's interesting, now that I'm retired from Metro High School, I'm having teachers reach out to me who know that I was a minister full-time and now I'm serving a church part-time, and I think I'm becoming the virtual chaplain for some of the teachers at Metro. And to use Linda's phrase, they are scared spitless about starting back to school tomorrow. But they're told this you must do. So for those who are going back to school, either because they choose to or because they're being told you have to, I would ask that we keep them in our thoughts and prayers. Racial tension is still the order of the day in our land and around the world, keeping that in our thoughts and prayers. We've run out of names, so now we've got Beta is the next hurricane coming in down in the southeastern United States. You know, we've gone to the Greek alphabet. So we've got them and a whole lot of derecho damage still unaddressed over in the Cedar Rapids, Marion area, and I'm sure other places as well. I mean, at least we finally got our person out to do the adjusting assessment, but now we got to try and find a contractor who has time to do work. And someone once told me that you know someone was special when they are praised by both their supporters and their detractors. And I was reading in the paper this morning about what all the other Supreme Court justices had to say about Ruth Bader Ginsburg. Those who were just as liberal as she was, and those who were 180 degrees conservative from what she was. And they all had nothing but praise for her service. So, prayers for our nation as we lose a very important female justice on our Supreme Court. And then I was told that Marlon Detman has cancer and we think has moved into hospice phase, at the very least has decided to quit treatments. So keeping Marlon and his family in our thoughts and prayers.
So I took my mom for what we thought was going to be a routine colonoscopy on Friday, and the doctor came back in and didn't even give me any forewarning when he just dropped the line that he found a massive cancer in my mother. So it's in her colon, and he couldn't give me any information at all about anything other than the fact that it had to be removed and very quickly. And so we did a CAT scan immediately, and now we're just waiting. We have 3 appointments this coming next week.
So prayers for, let's figure out what needs to be done and do it, and healing thereafter. Okay. Others?
Mary is going to have an upper GI on Wednesday, just a routine procedure. And our son Todd is going to have shoulder surgery on Thursday. And then also Hillary Kurtz Elf, that's married to Randy Elf, a cousin of the Crystal family that were longtime members of the church. She's in California and her cancer has returned, so she's gonna have to fight it again. She's a young person, just newly married in December.
You said her name is Melanie?
Hillary.
Hillary.
Yes.
I got the second Others.
The little lady, Joanne, that I had sent her on the call, came with Carolyn. After they did the testing at the hospital, later that night she had her gallbladder removed. It wasn't her heart at all. A lot easier.
Yeah.
Much easier, yes.
We can live without our gallbladder. And how old was this little
she's
one?
She's in her mid-80s.
Oh, okay.
And she, oh yeah, she's the founder and president of the mission store, and she was at the store.
Okay.
She happened to be one of the other volunteers who's just newly retired RN and said, you need to go to the hospital. No, I'll just go home and lay down. No, you need to go to the hospital.
It is interesting, because Linda's had her gallbladder out, and how gallbladder symptoms and heart attack symptoms, especially in females,
yes,
mimic each other.
Yes.
And when you first go in, a doctor is almost going to flip a coin until they run some tests. Mm-hmm. Well, it could be your heart. We hope it's your gallbladder. So, all right. Others?
Several of us from here were at a wedding reception last night with Matt Nissen and his wife. He is Bonnie Saunders Nissen's son. And those of us that knew Matt in his younger age, when he said, tomorrow morning at church, can you send up some prayers for our family? They've been together for a while, Matt and Carrie, and they have five teenagers, young adults between them. But he said, I think we could use some golden prayers, which coming from Matt, That's a pretty big thing. So he would just like prayers for their continued whatever ongoing.
They're now officially codified family.
Yes.
Okay. We can do that. Like I tell people, when you're not sure what else to do about yourself or someone who's struggling or is having a really good time of it, we can always pray. That's one thing we can always do, put it at the top of your list. Anybody else?
Yeah, prayers for my mom's, her first cousin. Her son passed away last week. He was 51 and had liver failure. And he's got kids and grandkids.
You know, say, depending upon when you started having kids at 51, you might even still have kids at home.
He doesn't have kids at home.
Okay.
But he works, they farm, and so, yeah, he farms with his family and brother, yeah.
I remember when I used to think 51 was old. Then I got a 6 in front of my age. I actually did used to own one of those t-shirts that says, never trust anybody over 30. It's long since gone. Anybody else?
I think we should all be thankful that we have fresh air to breathe. I talked to my friend Marty in Yamhill, Oregon the other night. She said, I would just about do anything for a breath of fresh air. When she goes outside, she's wearing one of the big heavy-duty masks. She's within about 20 miles of the big fires, and she said, I just can't breathe.
What do you call those, N95 or something?
Yeah.
Well, and the fact